President Trump offered some much-needed advice to embattled French President Emmanuel Macron. After calling the riots in Paris very sad, President Trump suggested that Macron end the Paris Agreement and give the money back to the people. WSLS10 reported that President Donald Trump blamed the Paris Climate Accord as demonstrations in France continued to protest over an increase in fuel tax and other grievances. "The Paris Agreement isn't working out so well for Paris," Trump tweeted Saturday morning. "Protests and riots all over France. People do not want to pay large sums of money, much to third world countries, that are questionably run, in order to maybe protect the environment." Macron is facing some of the worst rioting in France's history, due to his climate change taxes. The majority of French people feel their needs are ignored in lieu of global warming. Back in 2017, Macron chastised President Trump when he pulled the United States out of the Paris Climate Agreement. From Breitbart: U.S. President Donald Trump has weighed in on the growing chaos in Emmanuel Macron's France, calling it very sad and suggesting it is time to scrap the Paris Climate Agreement and return money back to the people in the form of lower taxes. Macron, who has become a hero to left liberals and something of a globalist poster boy after he bucked a populist surge on both sides of the Atlantic to win the French presidency, saw his poll rating crumble to 18% and his people out on the streets in their tens of thousands after he imposed a green fuel tax which fell heavily on rural people and the working class. The essentially leaderless gilets jaunes, better known as the yellow jackets or yellow vests to English speakers, have blocked roads and come out onto the streets of Paris in their thousands 4 weekends in a row now, and already forced the French leader to abandon the tax rise, but this has not been enough to mollify an increasingly revolution-minded populace, requiring him to deploy thousands of regular and paramilitary police to try and contain protests which have begun to take on the appearance of a civil insurrection. "Very sad day and night in Paris," observed the U.S. leader. "Maybe it's time to end the ridiculous and extremely expensive Paris Agreement and return money back to the people in the form of lower taxes." President Trump suggested the United States was way ahead of the curve in rejecting the supposedly anti-climate change accord, noting that his country, despite its refusal to sign it, is the only major country where emissions went down last year. President Macron has emerged as the global establishment's major champion for the agreement, as the electoral star of the left liberal mainstream's former alternative leader of the free world, Germany's Angela Merkel, has been decisively dimmed. Macron even threatened to veto a trade deal between the European Union, which negotiates trade agreements on its member states' behalf, and the South American trade bloc Mercosur, after a tropical Trump Jair Bolsonaro suggested he could follow his North American counterpart's lead in exiting the Paris Accord. As the situation in his home country continues to slide out of control, how much longer the embattled French president will remain able to throw his weight around in this manner remains to be seen.